Okay, my name's Rodney Russ. I own a company called Heritage Expeditions. We're an expedition travel company that offers expedition cruises for people interested in wildlife, natural history, wilderness. And we work in the Southern Ocean of New Zealand, down as far as Antarctica, go right down to the Ross Sea region. We also pioneering some programs right through the Bering Strait up to Wrangel Island, and as close as we get to the North Pole.
Hi, I'm Dave Bowen. I'm the commercial director for Heritage Expeditions. My job is the bottom line. Ultimately, I'm responsible for the financial health of the company, and because of that, I'm continually looking for ways for us to save money.
We operate a former polar research vessel called Professor Cromoff, but its trading name is Spirit of Enderby. We do all the maintenance, we do all the crewing, we do everything on this vessel. We're responsible for the day-to-day running of it.
Our biggest expense is fuel costs, by far. Any savings that we can affect on fuel usage drops straight to the bottom line.
We would burn on an average around about 1,500 tons of diesel every year.
Because of that, we did some fairly in-depth research into fuel additives to try and get better fuel consumption, and we'd stumble across Chornco.
I've read the literature, I've talked to those who promote it, and as a biologist myself, that's my background. I'm a business owner, but by default, and a ship operator, ship manager, but by default. I'm a biologist by training. I need to understand why, and that's what I'm struggling with a wee bit with Chornco now. I don't understand how this stuff can make the difference, but it does.
Some of the offers that we were given for Chornco were 3 or 4, up to 5% fuel savings. And in our business, that could be tens of thousands of dollars.
We often do same itineraries year in and year out. We're repeating the same itinerary, and so we can compare them.
At the time of the trial, we saved so much fuel on the first run that we thought potentially there was a mistake. So we subsequently went for 2 or 3 more trial runs over a period of 3 or 4 weeks. And the fuel savings is phenomenal. We've not 3 or 4 or 5%, we're actually saving almost 30%. Last voyage, we had a 29% fuel savings on the same period last year.
We're also, from an environmental point of view, we're very aware that we burn significant amount of fuel, and our passengers are very aware of their carbon footprint. And so if we can make savings in reducing our carbon footprint by reducing the amount of fuel we burn, then that's a good sales pitch as well. And you know, from a personal point of view, I'm very conscious of the amount of fuel I burn, and so I'm always looking for savings in that regard as well.
When you have 30% savings in fuel usage, basically you've reduced your carbon footprint by 30%. And what we're talking about, all these ways to ride our bike to work and turn the lights down low, 30% of our fuel usage, which is a major contributor to our footprint, is a phenomenal savings. And if somebody is very concerned about their carbon footprints, I'd suggest they look at Chornco.
One of our problems that we did have was we had on startup, we had sooty, black smoke and soot that used to come from the exhaust stack and fall on gear and equipment. You can imagine being in Antarctica, beautiful, pristine place. It's absolutely amazing. And then to start up the engines, have a bit of a cloud of black smoke up there. It didn't look good. We've actually got rid of all the soot. It's been amazing. We now no longer have a soot problem. We start up, we're not getting that belch of black smoke. We're getting clean decks. All our equipment is clean. That's been for me one of the most remarkable things that this does is on startup.
My concern was not that it wouldn't do anything. My concern was it would do damage, and that was our biggest concern. You add a fuel additive into a engine that's running pretty darn good, and what if it runs worse? And so that was my biggest concern, and very pleasantly surprised. The engines are running better, they're running cooler, they're running less, we're getting fantastic fuel savings. It's for us, it's a win-win all the way around.
Remember that I have a chief engineer, and although I am his boss and that I am the charter, I also have to convince him as well. He was very much a skeptic the first time, but when he started seeing the figures, he's convinced. He's a convert now.
There were a couple of concerns that we may potentially use some extra filters due to the particulates coming out of the fuel, but so far that has not been the case. The engines are running as good or better than they ever have.
there's no hassle with loading it. It's done at the point of loading. It's just mixed, so there's no further work to do with it. There's nothing during a course of a voyage that we have to manage with it. It's very simple. It's removed the black smoke at our startup. It's got rid of the soot off that came associated with that startup. We're seeing cost savings and the amount of fuel we're using, and that's got to be good for the bottom line.
It's fantastic. It's unbelievable. We were able to drop over $100,000 to our bottom line this year with one product. One decision I've made has added basically over $100,000 over the last 9 months to the bottom line. Yeah, we're ecstatic.